Please, you come tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes.
And come back on?
Wednesday.
So we keep the open, that's good. Ah, things going. Which is Ananda?
Okay. If you ask how much is going?
Yes.
A little bit better.
A little bit better?
Yes, more energy than I
had before. How is your samadhi?
Not yet great, but I have a little bit more sati. I can see it. Oh, okay, there's a sort of coming. Getting something coming, and especially my
Kama Chandra
problem that I had so much, I can now
Kama
Chandra?
Sexual assault. Oh, okay.
They're coming, it's there, I can see it.
Yeah, that will, you know, I mean, not only
you. Yeah, I mean, if they come back.
Every one of us, you know, is bothered by these things, you know, that constantly come up. Yeah? that's why we have to have these pictures. Yeah, these are super pictures. Yeah, the moment you know Raga Tanha comes up, you know, we remember the super picture and place it in there, and instantly, you know, Raga Tanha disappears. Yeah, at the moment the picture becomes a little bit blurred, you know, and another picture forms, you know, I mean, then Raga Tanha comes back again, yeah, and then you have to do it again, and then you now comes back again, do it again, and so on, until there's more stable things.
My desires are like that day
I
over the time, like, start to use it for their desire as well. You understand what I mean?
I mean, you cannot use it. That is the kilesas wanting, you know, to lure you. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
I mean that as a tool, it's getting weaker. Verstehst du was ich meine? Also du hast ein Bild, das eigentlich irgendwie abschreckend, ethisch oder was auch immer sein soll.
Ach so.
Und dann
okay.
Die aber sozusagen so abgehärtet davon, dass sie sich selbst das, was eigentlich abstoßend ist, noch greifen und in diesem Trieb verbauen.
Yeah, no, I mean, you have to use it, and then you have to ask questions, you know, I mean, is that what I'm looking for, is that what I want to hug, you know, or this is what, you know, this is the inside of me, you know, when I look at the food, you know, that goes into the mouth, and then look at the food that comes out, yeah, I mean, do I want to eat it again, yeah, no, me not, yeah. I mean, so use anything, you know. I mean, if one picture becomes, you know, a little bit blurred out, you know, use another picture, you know. Or use, you know, sometimes, you know, I use very, very harsh method, you know. I use a chainsaw, yeah. And, you know, yeah. And all this blood, you know, spurting out, and then, you know, and then so on, yeah. Yeah. Or, you know, you just slice it up, you know, slice it in the middle, look at two halves, yeah. This normally works, you know, very well, yeah. Use it, you know, I mean, of course, you know, I mean, once the kilesas know, you know, that one thing is, you know, against them, you know, that they fade it out, yeah. So we have to use a new trick, yeah. In the beginning, you know, a trick that we use, you know, works maybe for a month or maybe for 2 months, yeah? And then it works for 1 week, and then it works for 1 day, and then it works for 10 or 15 minutes, and you constantly have to change, you know? Yeah?
Ärger.
Und das tue
ich bei mir nicht, weshalb ich denke, ich mache was falsch.
Nein, du machst es noch nicht richtig. Du siehst dieses Grauen, das hochkommt, das kommt noch nicht richtig hoch, weil du noch spielst.
Okay.
Ja.
Aber wenn es angenehm und beruhigend ist und man sich eigentlich...
Wenn es angenehm und beruhigend ist, normalerweise, was ich vorhin in Teil gesagt habe, Normalerweise, während wir die Asuka machen, kommt die Wut nicht hoch. Die kommt danach hoch. Da kommt der Ärger hoch, ne, da siehst du irgendwann so einen Wusch geht drauf. Ne? Während der Meditation, während der Untersuchung, kommt es nie hoch. Da ist das Interesse, da wir wollen schauen, wollen wir sehen und so weiter. Ne? Da kommt also kein Ärger hoch.
Okay, und wenn es so ist, dass ich. Also ich habe irgendwas ist passiert, ich habe eine starke Emotion, ich setze mich hin, ich meditiere, ich mache das super, ich stelle mir meinen Körper als Leiche vor,
ja.
Finde ich total super, beruhige mich, ich komme raus und es geht mir besser, mache ich dann nicht irgendwas.
Ja, dann hast du Samadhi mit einem anderen Objekt gemacht.
Worauf ich hinaus will, ich glaube, es ist irgendwo diese Vernichtung, die mich auch befriedigt. Verstehst du, wie ich meine?
Ja, ich verstehe schon, was du meinst. Ne? Aber das ist noch.
Also einfach weitermachen.
Ja, ich würde mehr in das Grausamere reingehen, in das wirklich Abschreckende. Ne? Ja, wenn du zum Beispiel eine Wasserleiche.
Ja, ich wollte gerade sagen, ich nehme immer eine Wasserleiche.
Ja? Ja, und stinkt die richtig?
Ja.
Ja, gut.
Die ist
ja.
Ganz
ja, es geht. Es ist möglich, ne? wenn wir es super machen, dass wir in Samadhi reinfallen, ne? Und dann geht es uns danach gut. Ne? Das Wichtige ist bei der Super, die Fragen zu stellen. Ja? Die richtigen Fragen. Sorry, zeig mir mal, ne? Wenn ich das aufgemacht habe, und aufgeblättert wurde. Ne? Dann nehme ich jetzt ein Messer, ne? Oder eine Säge, oder ich säge den Brustkorb auf, ne? Und dann schaue ich, dann nehme ich das Herz in die Hand oder die Lunge in die Hand. Das sind nicht angenehme Dinge, ne? Okay? Fandest du? Ne? I don't want to talk very much, but you know, I mean, the lay people who are here, you know, every one of us have to realize that the life as a human being is very fortunate if we use it correctly. There are 31 realms of existence, right? And we went probably through all of these realms, you know, once in a while, you know, maybe some of the realms we haven't been to, but. So the problem is, you know, or the advantage of the life as a human being is that we can see dukkha and sukha. Dukkha is a dissatisfaction and sukha is a satisfaction at about the same amount. If you have too much sukha, if you have too much satisfaction, nobody of you would come here. If you have too much dukkha, nobody would come here. It takes an amount, you know, and this amount, you know, can help us, you know, can help us to make the most out of our human life. And the most out of our human life is to find the way out of the samsara. Find the way out of the hamster wheel, yeah. Or sometimes I call it roller coaster, yeah. You go up, you know, and you go up to heaven, and you go down to heaven, and then you go up to heaven, and you go down to heaven. And so on. And then we come back as a human being, you know, to create enough karma, you know, to go up or to go down. Yeah? Some people, you know, just go up to the human level and then go down to hell. And then go up to the human level and go down to hell. while they are, you know, in the meantime they are in the ghost realm, you know, before they become as a human being. And for us, you know, I mean, realizing this, you know, I mean, our purpose in our life, you know, you should really consider, you should really think about, you know, what you want to do with your life, right? I mean, now you are in touch with Buddhism, now you're in touch with the correct sasana, with the correct teaching, you know, that leads to the end of dukkha, yeah? That leads out of samsara, yeah? What do you want to do? You want to waste your time, yeah? After 3 weeks or 5 weeks, go back, you know, and then, you know, I mean, live the life that was not satisfactory in the party, yeah? And then after a while, you're now living outside, you come back, I don't know, no, it is not satisfactory, and then you do it again, and then you get torn by your kilesas, and then you go out again, you know, you live outside, you know, and then you come back, yeah? No, I mean, see, you know, I mean, consider it, you know, consider what you want to do with your life, yeah? Think about very carefully, you know? Do you want to use this life? And one life is not enough, you know, to end samsara. I mean, you wouldn't be here if you hadn't been practicing before. You have been practicing for many lives, yeah? I mean, you went to kindergarten, you know, primary school, and maybe high school, you know, and then, you know, you start university. How many lifetimes, you know, does it take, you know, at university level, you know, to become an arahant? Long, long time, yeah? So, but we don't know what happened in our last life, you know, but we can try, you know, at least we can try, make the most out of this human life, you know, to become at least a Jodhapana at the end of the stream, you know, or a non-returner, or even an arahant. I mean, it is up to us, you know, how much effort we put into the practice, yeah? And not to give in, yeah? Not to give in to the kilesas, oh, it's so difficult. What is difficult? Nothing is difficult. One breath, you know, I mean, we can always do one breath. Oh, one breath, we can always do one breath. What is difficult of doing one breath? Huh? It's the kilesas who constantly tell us what is happening, what is going on, you know, what we want and what we don't want. It's not the Dhamma that tells us. The Dhamma wants to sit there and practice, right? It's a kilesas, oh no, yeah, I mean I should take a rest, you know, oh I should sleep now, I'm so tired, you know. It's a kilesas to tell, yeah. It's not us, it's not the Dhamma. Yeah? The Dhamma wants to practice, yeah. Normally, you know, as a hardcore practitioner, I mean you sleep when you're not tired, yeah. When you're tired, you don't sleep, yeah. You just do walking meditation or sitting meditation, yeah. And then, you know, when you're not tired and you put your head on the pillow, you instantly are gone, yeah, for 1 or 2 hours, yeah, oops, gone. Very deep sleep, and then you wake up, and then you practice again. Takes a little while, you know, to get used to it. In the beginning, you know, we sleep only for 5 hours, then for 4 hours, then for 3 hours, yeah. Until we come, you know, to intensive practice, you know, where we just sleep for 2 hours, yeah. And the rest of the day we practice, yeah. Because the longer we sleep, yeah, when we sleep very long, yeah, I mean we dream along, yeah, and so all the practice of the previous day is gone, yeah. I mean, so many thoughts, so many dreams, you know, and all these things, you know, coming on, you know, and then we have to fight again, and then in the evening, oh, we're so tired, you know, and then we sleep 6 hours, you know, and then the next day is the same thing, yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, cut down on sleep, yeah. And go through the difficulties in our 3 or 4 or 5 days, yeah? Just the same thing as with fasting, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 days, you know, until it takes effect, yeah? And then we are not tired anymore. Yeah? We're practicing, and the more we practice samadhi, the less we need sleep. The better our samadhi, the less we need sleep. Okay, use your time, you know, use your time while you're here to practice, yeah. That's all what I want to say today, just about if there are questions, you know, you can ask now, yeah.
Yeah, Thanaja, I was wondering, you mentioned talking about being in the stream and
being in the what?
In the stream,
yeah.
Entry. And I was wondering, like, do you know if you're like far enough, like, do you know if you enter it that you can just stay in it or can you fall out of it? You know, or
what do you mean with being in the
like
stream?
Like Sotapanna.
Sotapanna, that means entering the stream.
Yeah, and like, can
yeah,
you know
that?
You
it is very clear.
Oh.
Yeah. But if you think you are, you're not. Yeah? Either you know it or you don't know it. And that is the thing that we have to practice in samadhi, yeah? To know or to think. Yeah? The difference I mean, the thinking is very noisy. The knowing is very subtle. The moment you know the breath, you know the breath. Yeah? The moment, as long as you think you know the within breath or out breath, or you know slow or fast, deep or shallow, yeah? That is not knowing, not yet knowing. Once you know, it is very subtle, yeah? But you know. Yeah? And nobody can argue with that. Yeah? The whole world can say, no, you are not, you know, but you know you are. It is a very decisive moment, you know, I mean, you will not forget it. Yeah? So don't worry about it. Don't think you are, yeah, because then you are not. So many people. I have met so many people in these 25 years around, 28 years. Oh, you know, I'm coming from Myanmar. Oh, I'm Sotapanna, I'm Sakadapanna. Happy, I'm happy for you. They are not. They think, you know, I mean, it is, I mean, we are learned, you know, as Westerners, we are so much learned, you know. We can learn all the suttas, we understand the suttas, I mean, absolutely to the point, and we really think, you know, okay, there is anatta, you know, there is not me, not mine, all these things are not me, not mine. Why is there still this attachment? Because if we really understood that it's not me, not mine, not myself, yeah, I mean, there's no attachment, there's no wish, there's no desire, yeah. So as long as there is desire, you know, I mean, you're not finished. But we learn, you know, and then we studied that, and we trained our mind, you know, and the younger you are, you know, I mean, the more rich this training was, yeah. You never question anything that was taught to you, you know. I mean, at my time, you know, we question things, you know, I mean, if the teacher told us something, we sometimes question it, you know, what was it, why you say it like this, why is it like this, you know, or what if I do it like this, you know, I mean, we question it. But nowadays, you know, people don't question, they just learn, and then, you know, they know, yeah, but this is not the same kind of knowing that comes from the heart. It's a knowing that comes from the brain, from our understanding. Yeah? So if you read the suttas, some people read the suttas, they're not much better than me, I hardly can remember anything. Read the suttas, you know, understand the teaching of the Lord Buddha, you know, and in the end they say, okay, I'm finished. Yeah? I don't have to go through the hardship of practicing samadhi. Yeah? Or I don't have to go through the hardship of investigation. Why did the Lord Buddha talk about samadhi? Sila, samadhi, panya. Sila, samadhi, and wisdom. Yeah? Developing wisdom. And wisdom becomes through investigation. And investigation becomes through observing one thing, you know, be it a feeling, be it a thought, be it a memory, be it a body, yeah? And asking the right question about it. Yeah? That's where we gain wisdom. Asking the right question. What is this body? When I open it up, how does it look? Well, show me, yeah? And the chitta can show us everything, yeah? We have gone through so many deaths, yeah? I mean, show me when I died, you know, how was it, yeah? when you're burned as a witch, you know, how was it, yeah? Go through the whole experience, you know, feel it, you know? Huh? Or when you were torn, you know, between four horses, you know? Or when you died of thirst in the desert, yeah? I mean, we went through it. Or, you know, when we were all soldiers, you know? Huh? When we were wounded, you know, and left alone on the field and nobody cared about us, and we did for days, you know, we died very slowly. Yeah? I mean, the chitta can show us all these steps. Yeah? It's quite revealing, yeah? It shows us, yeah? I mean, to how many deaths have we got? Yeah? And how many more deaths do we want to go through, yeah, in our lives? Yeah? Because if this life, you know, we are dying and then we are born in another realm, yeah? Sooner or later we come back as a human being, then we are born again, then we have to study, but then we have to learn about this body, we have to train this body for 18 years until we can use it, and then we can use it for 30 years or 40 years, you know, and then it slowly decays until, you know, the breath stops, you know, and we die. Yeah? Or we die very painfully because, you know, because of an illness, you know, because of cancer, or a very painful death, you know, I mean, there are so many different kinds of diseases, and, yeah. And it never stops, yeah, unless we put a stop to it. Okay, so, another question. And then come and read the questions, yeah.
The person is also asking about body contemplation, and he sees that most of the thoughts, he can just let them be, the sexual thoughts, without following them, and sometimes he just has a look, and then he's realizing that they overcome him, and yeah, they trick him. So he's asking if he just should continue body investigation, or also try to understand all these tricks of the Kilesas that try to pull him in, and also...
The tricks of the Kilesas are immeasurable. Yeah, I mean, they live with us for millions of lives, you know, so they know everything. They know us better than everyone, and they can pull our legs, you know, they can twist our arms, they can twist our back, you know. I mean, yeah. Don't try, you know, to outsmart them, because that's the Kilesas trying to outsmart the Kilesas, right? And that never works. No, do for the investigation, you know, until there are some results. And you will see the results, you know, as I said before, but maybe it was in German, after the body investigation, anger comes up.
Yeah.
And you see something and anger comes up. You see a person, you know, you see him doing something, and you never got angry, but then after your investigation, you suddenly get so pissed, you know, so angry.
Yeah.
Or you get angry, you know, at these at these mosquitoes, you know, normally they don't bother you so much, you know, but then you get really upset, you know. And that means, you know, your body investigation is working. But also over the time you will see, you know, that slowly detachment from the bodily sensation will creep in. No, don't try to outsmart the Kilesas. I tried it and they're always true.
Yeah, he says sometimes it even arises when things unexpected happen, like for example just seeing a woman's name in
the email. Yeah. This kind of, I mean, when I was sitting, you know, when I was in Trudong, you know, and I was just practicing, you know, and I mean, 2 kilometers away, you know, some women, you know, were on the field, you know, and chanting, you know, were singing and speaking, and whoosh! Yeah. I mean, it instantly comes up, yeah. Mm-hmm. And then you have to remedy that.
Okay, and there's one other question, that was how long is the sasana still alive?
The sasana itself is still alive another 2,450 years, or 40 years. But the real teaching will go down from now. So, I mean, you will not find in 2,500 or 2,000 years still around. There won't be any around. So there will be no living sasana, there will be just a dead sasana. I mean, dead sasana in forms of books, you know, in forms of teaching. Now it is a time. Or, you know, you wait for the next Buddha, you know, in about, what is it, in about 100,000 years, you know, and when the next Buddha comes down, and then the sasana is there. It comes and it goes. So, I would think maybe 100, 200 years, you know, they are still practicing monks, yeah? And when they are still practicing monks, you know, who attain to Sotapanna, Sakadapanna, Anapanna, or Arahant, that still means, you know, you can still, you know, find the way out. If there are no more monks, you know, if there is just a teaching, I mean, it is very, very difficult. These just 2 questions, so, I mean, yeah. Now it's the time, yeah. I mean, Thailand is the country, you know, is the land, you know, where the sasana really flourished, yeah. I mean, over 100 arahants in the last 100 years, yeah. There's no other country in the whole world, you know, who had so many Arahants. Yeah? So the teaching is still very predominant, and the teaching is still very pure. Yeah? So, I mean, if you follow the teaching of these Arahants, yeah, like never another teaching master, you know, I mean, you still can reach, you know, sort of Anasakavatam or Arahant. Yeah? But it's not easy.
Question about past lives. I don't doubt that they're real, but I've never experienced them. And
yeah.
So when I hear about how many eons I've been doing this, it's like a something I would read in a book. It doesn't have any impact. It doesn't really inspire me or do anything. I just hear like, oh, that sounds nice. And if the chitta does go on, well, it's like, well, it doesn't feel like me. So I guess I just wonder how to relate to that in a way that it can be inspiring and help me practice rather than just be kind of empty words.
You mean the past life, yeah?
Yeah.
Why don't you think about death and the next life?
Well, the same. As past lives, future lives, they just all don't feel real to me.
Yeah, and this life, yeah? And death, does it feel real to you?
This life and death, yes.
Yeah. It really doesn't matter. Yeah, I mean previous life, I mean whatever you have done, yeah, whatever karma you have done in your previous life, the results of your karma, I mean you experience now in this life. I mean how are people reacting to you? How fast are you learning? Yeah? How wealthy are you? Yeah? It's all the result of your karma of previous life. Yeah? So from the things that happened to you, you can look back, you know, and see what kind of things you have done in the past in order to get these results that you're right, yeah? And the same thing, you know, I mean, if you do something, yeah, and if you understand a little bit about karma, so for people, you know, what did the Lord Buddha say, yeah? People, you know, who are very helpful, you know, who you know, I mean, who don't consider themselves, who only are there for others, in the next life they are very beautiful, yeah? Or if they speak truthfully, you know, and if they speak sweet, you know, not lies, yeah? Not white lies, and if they speak sweet, you know, they have a beautiful voice, yeah? Or if they are very generous, you know, they will become very wealthy in the next life, not in this life, yeah? That is, you know, I mean, look, you know, I mean, look what happened to you in this life, you know, and then you can infer, you know, what happened, what you did in your previous life, yeah? And then it doesn't become just a picture, yeah? I mean, go through your life, you know, I mean, start with a birth, or go back, you know, last year, what happened to me last year? And then what happened to me 2 years, you know, until you come back to birth, yeah? And then, you know, you can even go back, you know, I mean, what happened before birth, yeah? Maybe you know, maybe you remember, maybe you don't. It is just not so important, yeah? The important thing is, you know, what we do right now. Yeah? And what kind of effect will it have on our next life? Or, yeah, sometimes, you know, in this life, you know, when we practice very hard, yeah? When we practice so hard, you know, that we... Some people, you know, come very close to Sotapanna, to stream entry, and in the next life, you know, they just fall into the stream, yeah? Because they are very close to the door, yeah? But in this life, they cannot make it yet, yeah? There's something missing, or there's some attachment, you know, but then in the next life, they can make it, yeah? Just like in Mukalana and Sariputta, you know, I mean, they just listen to one of the months of the Lord Buddha, you know, and they instantly got Sotapanna, yeah? They instantly understood, they realized, yeah? And the only other one, you know, who became Arahant was Anyapandanya, yeah? The other four, they had to work very hard, yeah? And it always says in the suttas, you know, after a short time, you know, they became Arahant. The short time is 20, 30, 40, 50 years, yeah? So, but they were born at a time because they had so much merit, yeah? They had so much merit that they were born at the time of the Lord Buddha, yeah? But we have so much merit that we are born, you know, at a time, you know, where there are so many arahants. Yeah? That's also very good karma, and that we find a place, yeah? That we come here to Thailand and find a place and find the teacher. Okay? So, anything else? No? Okay. Nothing there? Yeah, don't waste the time as a monk, you know?
Yeah, I mean,